our quartz crystal oscillator trainer key. This is the oscillator trainer key. There are four types of crystal oscillator here. These are the circuit diagram. This is the CMOS crystal oscillator with non-inverting op-amp. This is the transistor-based oscillator circuit. This is TTL square wave crystal oscillator circuit. And this is CMOS Pierce type oscillator circuit. So here on this circuit, we can see there is a component named XTAL. So this is the crystal. The crystal, when we applied a voltage to this crystal, the crystal starts to vibrate. The frequency of vibration is equal to the frequency of applied voltage. And here these are the test point. This is TP test point 3, where we can observe the output waveforms. So, and this is the main switch to turn on or off the key. User manual and patch codes are included in this kit, and to perform the experiments and to observe the waveforms, we will need an oscilloscope. So first, we are going to observe the output waveform on CMOS crystal oscillator. CMOS crystal oscillator with non-inverting op-amp. So connect the ground terminal of the CRO here and turn on the key. And we can see the square wave on the DSO. Now we will observe the output waveform of transistor based crystal oscillator. So here we will get a sine wave. This is a sine wave. Here the frequency is 34.36 kilohertz. This is the frequency that we have got, we have received from practical experiment, and this is the frequency of theoretical. This is the theoretical frequency, 32.768 kilohertz. So note down this frequency and compare the difference between theoretical value and practical value. Next, we will observe the output waveform of TTL square wave crystal oscillator. This is the output waveform. So here we can see the frequency is 32.77 kilohertz, and the theoretical value is the 32.768 kilohertz. Now we will observe the output waveform here. This is the waveform here, and the frequency is 32.75 kilohertz.